Embroidery Studio provides various techniques for auto-digitizing photographs. In this video, we focus on the sometimes overlooked photo flash feature. Photo flash was originally intended to create embroidery from color or grayscale photographs. The effect resembles the output of a line printer. As such, the technique can be used for keepsakes and mementos, but it can also be used with design artwork to create appealing commercial embroidery. This video explores techniques used for the creation of embroidery design with Embroidery Studio's Photo Flash. First, we look at creating a keepsake from a photo. Results depend greatly on the resolution and color depth. For best results, use crisp images with well-defined subjects and strong contrasts. The first distinction you need to be aware of is whether the image employs a solid or a transparent background. This needs to be prepared in a graphics application before bringing into Embroidery Studio. If you're using it in combination with the cropping tools, the second factor which affects photo flash output is background size. The background can be oversized to accommodate a cropping area which extends beyond the image itself. Here we create an oval frame around our oversized background. This results in an oval-shaped photo flash object. Once the object is generated, we can experiment with our photo flash settings to arrive at a satisfying result. The most important setting is potentially row angle. Photo flash objects have their own stitch properties in addition to object properties. Switching to the Fills tab, we can experiment with the photo satin settings. Note the interplay between row angle and skew angle. Alternatively, we can create a photo flash object from an image with transparency. Note how the background is ignored altogether. Combining photo flash with duplicate objects, additional colors and creative stitch types can create interesting effects. Here we combine a photo flash object with an underlying accordion spacing object to create a sense of light and shade. Here we use the same techniques to convert graphic design to photo flash embroidery. Having scaled our artwork, we begin by digitizing a cropping area with the Crop Any Shape tool. This can be easily converted to photo flash embroidery. Using the Remove Crop tool, we revert to the uncropped image. From here, we can create our Column C borders. Add lettering to complete the picture. To add volume and color to Photo Flash, we create a tatami background object and apply accordion spacing. For more information about Embroidery Studio Photo Flash, consult the online help or reference manual.